modern ships are extraordinarily seaworthy crafts, built to exacting standards of construction and outfitted with technology worthy of spaceships. However, even the best ships can capsize or sink with terrifying speed. And equipment is only as good as the personnel who operate it. Thus, it is essential that shipboard crew is aware of the principles and techniques of sea survival and well trained in the use of survival equipment. The life-saving appliances to be carried by ships must be in accordance with the SOLAS, or Safety of Life at Sea Convention, Chapter 3, and with any additional requirements of the National Administration. Every person on board should be familiar with the contents of the muster list, the general emergency alarm, and the location of the emergency stations. The muster list describes the emergency alarm signals and the action to be taken by the crew and passengers when this alarm is sounded. It further describes the special duties assigned to some crew members, which include closing of watertight doors, fire doors, scuppers, ventilators, etc. Preparation of survival crafts and other life-saving appliances. Proper muster of crew and passengers. Special duties assigned to crew pertaining to the use of firefighting equipments and installations. Officers responsible for maintenance of life-saving and firefighting appliances, and how the order to abandon ship will be given. Life jackets will not sustain burning after being totally enveloped in a fire for a period of 2 seconds. They are so constructed that they can be donned within a minute and can turn the body of an unconscious person face up, allowing him to breathe. Life jackets are fitted with a whistle and a fixed or flashing light, which burns for at least 8 hours. As far as possible, jumping into the water must be avoided, and ladders and ropes must be used to board survival crafts. However, if it is necessary to jump, the height must not exceed 4.5 meters. And the life jacket should be clasped firmly to the chest by one hand and the nose blocked by the other. Lifebuoys are made up of inherently buoyant and non-inflammable material. A grab line is secured to the lifebuoy in 4 loops. Lifebuoys may be attached with buoyant non-kinking lifelines or self-igniting lights. Man overboard lifebuoys, normally located near the bridge wings, are attached with self-igniting lights and self-activating smoke signals. Immersion suits are made of waterproof material and will not sustain burning after being totally enveloped in a fire for a period of 2 seconds. Immersion suits can be donned in 2 minutes without assistance and cover the whole body except the face. The immersion suit will permit the person wearing it to perform all the normal duties associated with abandoned ship. Immersion suits complying with the requirements of a life jacket may be classified as a life jacket. Alternatively, a life jacket shall be worn over the immersion suit. Thermal protective aids are made of waterproof insulating material and can be used to help people who have lost a lot of body heat due to immersion in cold water. It covers the whole body of a person wearing a life jacket except the face and is capable of being donned without assistance in a survival craft. The Global Maritime Distress and Safety Systems, or GMDSS, is specifically designed to automate a ship's radio distress alerting function. One of the principal advantages is that the system is actually an amalgam of various individual radio systems consisting of a VHF radio capable of transmitting and receiving digital selective calling, DSC, and radio telephony. A medium frequency radio telephone installation. An Inmarsat ship Earth station with enhanced group calling for receiving safety, weather, navigational warnings, etc. A nav text receiver used for the automatic broadcast of localized maritime safety information. Epirb, or emergency position indicating radio beacon, is designed to operate with satellites, including polar orbiting satellites. Its signal allows a satellite to accurately locate the Epirb and identify the vessel anywhere in the world without any range limitation. Rescue coordinated centers are subsequently alerted via the satellite and rescue crafts dispatched to the casualty. Epirbs can be operated either manually or automatically with the help of a hydrostatic release unit. SART, or Search and Rescue Radar Transponder. This is a buoyant, portable, manually operated locating device which is triggered by the radar beams of ships and aircrafts. A series of response signals are generated when interrogated by radar, and these signals produce blips on the radar screen of the rescue ship or aircraft. Three sets of two-way handheld VHF having International Radio Channel 16 and other channels are used for emergency communication between ship and survival crafts. Early action during a man overboard situation is the key to saving a life. If a person is seen falling overboard when the ship is underway, the nearest lifebuoy or other buoyant object should be immediately released, the alarm raised, and the helm put hard over to the side from which the man has fallen. The signal O can be made on the whistle and corresponding flag hoisted to warn the vessels in the vicinity. For the ship to return to the position where the man had fallen overboard, the Williamson turn is a maneuver commonly used. After turning under full helm through a deviation of around 60 degrees, the rudder is put hard over in the opposite direction to bring the vessel around to the reciprocal of the original course. In case the casualty is not located, a search must be initiated immediately using suitable search patterns like the sector search and the expanding square search. The rescue boat is launched as soon as the casualty is sighted and a lee made by the ship to facilitate the rescue.